Hello, beta testers. Did you hear? Hogwarts Legacy has become not only PlayStation 5, but Steam's bestseller as well. Pretty good for a game that hasn't even come out yet, huh? Maybe you're not the type to pre-order, or maybe you're on the fence because some people are being kinda strange about a harmless video game purchase online. Fear not. What they say is far from true, and if you want to play a game, that's okay. I'm sorry you need to be assured, but we all have our shortcomings, so smile to remind yourself that you still can, because some of these people seem to get out even less than I do, and they've made a literal inanimate object to their enemy, a horcrux, if you will. If you don't do whatever they say and think whatever they tell you to, you're not an ally, and therefore are against them? As a person who's fought for my life, I take literal offense to keyboard SJWs applying terms like allies to their confused online crusades against popular billionaire authors, who gave so much of their own money away that they've lost that status. But bigger, better, and smarter men, women, and people who identify as neither have fought, died, and are currently laying down their lives so people like this can have whatever opinion they like. I'm afraid deciding what another person means by their harmless action, unfortunately, is where I draw the line. I previously asserted that trolls had likely infested or infiltrated Twitter, Reddit communities, whatever Reset Era is. They're clearly obsessed with pretending that buying a video game is somehow harmful to a certain group of people. As a black man that likes chicken, I've been called homophobic by psychopaths. So I've learned to dismiss them like the boggarts they are. Ridiculous. A Hogwarts game would probably have trolls in it too. Maybe that's why they're upset? They don't want the competition. But unfortunately, I didn't consider the scariest scenario of all. That members of the trans community might actually be proud to harbor these deranged and logic-free sentiments. That buying a game is equal to wishing a person or group ill? I was recently watching an Indian film called Lakshmi, where a man gets possessed by a spirit of a dead transgender man. At one point in the movie, a man says, "A full moon is coming, so all the transgender will gather by the seashore." To which I said, "You want to run that by me again?" You see, listener, I may not be the most well-versed when it comes to rituals within the transgender community, but sense of the common variety imparted on me with certainty that, yeah, maybe that doesn't happen. However, imagine if you will that for some reason, I did believe it, and contrary to any proof that people may provide, I adamantly held firm to not only this belief, but the belief that if anyone thought differently, that made them a bigot. That'd be absurd, right? A world with fantastic dyed-haired beasts, but you wouldn't want to know where to find them. I plan to buy this upcoming Harry Potter game, contrary to what these woke modern gaming activists believe, because Hogwarts Legacy is not some sort of KKK guide. It wouldn't be appealing to me if it were, but logic never got in the way of him in the first place, so why start now? The point of this video was to celebrate that Hogwarts is the best-selling game of 2023. Not because of intentional or deceptive marketing, but because of showcases by developers demonstrating this game as a true dream come true. And moreover, as a musician, as an artist, and an experienced gamer with functional eyes, bad games these days are developed by, boy, lazy people desperate to tell you what is good. And that's never been how this works. You can't convince the consumer that your objectively lackluster and inferior dropping is actually treasure. I've paid attention to many of the same people in these bizarre communities arguing for the removal of curvy women from video games, arguing that a certain race wearing a hairstyle is cultural appropriation and that they shouldn't be allowed to do that. They shill these dated, slow-motion, buggy, unfinished cash grabs, kicked out the door by lazy swindlers, ironically claiming to fight for inclusivity while excluding harmless things they simply don't like. But every drop of attention these people feed this game is turning into sales, and anyone with sense would recognize there's a growing percentage of people who simply will buy this game to spite woke Western garbage, ruining these games with this fake modern audience dribble. This is no disrespect for any self-respecting transgender person who hasn't confused a game with a war. I'm a gamer fed up with being told how I should feel. You know, I'm a black man laughing at what I'm assured I should be offended by. And as much as I beg anyone listening to be cautious, to hesitate, to scrutinize, to wait for reviews from a trusted source, a personal trusted source, and for the love of God to let your own eyes be the judge, the truth that I'm well aware of as a fan is if you're a fan too, you will be playing this. These online hypocrites have absolutely no power over your life or what you harmlessly choose to do in the comfort of your own home. They seek to turn your escape entertainment into dated education, but they have only as much power as you give them. My heart goes out to the developers who will be forced to endure review bombs, but rest assured, the financial support is there. And if it just performs well, there's more where that came from. If you made it this far, thank you. Thank you for the likes, the subscriptions, to the sponsors, to the patrons. I love you. And to anybody on either side of this, if you haven't heard it today, you are loved. Take a break from all of this.